Human rights groups have condemned the prison sentence of the 26-year-old Egyptian blogger Michael Nabil. His jailing raises questions whether the regime in Egypt has changed at all since former President Hosni Mubarak stood down. Zena Khodr with this report from Cairo.
Amr is well aware that publishing posts critical of Egypt's new rulers, the military, could get him into trouble. But this Egyptian blogger believes he is doing nothing wrong by expressing his views. Michael Nabil, a fellow blogger, however, was sentenced to 3 years in jail by a military tribunal for a blog he wrote titled, "The People and the Army Were Never Hand in Hand." He was charged with insulting the army and spreading false news. He is the first blogger to be tried by the new leadership.
If we're all speaking freely, then they can't arrest us all. They can arrest one of us and they'll get him, but it's not going to be everybody's.
Michael was sentenced in the absence of his lawyer. Human rights groups criticized the move, saying it sets a dangerous precedent.
Michael's conviction was a clear message to journalists and activists not to criticize the military. We intend to repeal the verdict and ask for a retrial, but we are not expecting much.
In his blog, Michael said the army used violence against protesters. He claimed the army used the Egyptian museum as a place to torture civilians, and the military forced detained women protesters to take virginity tests. Accusations echoed by human rights groups.
The Supreme Council of the Armed Forces is defending its position. It says the army is open to criticism when criticism is made with good intentions. A council member said the problem is in questioning the intentions of the military. Lawyers say that is not a crime. In fact, Michael was not the first to question the actions and motives of the military.
Protesters are now demanding the army hand over power to a transitional presidential council. The military have arbitrarily arrested hundreds and tried civilians in military courts. The government acknowledges tensions have crept into the army's relationship with the population and has been trying to ease concerns.
The army has protected the revolution. There is a third group of hooligans hoping for the return of the old regime. They are trying to create a division between the people and the army. They haven't been able to do so.
A growing number of Egyptians are concerned the military is using the same tactics as the ousted Mubarak regime, a regime that feared the power of the internet, a power which helped lead to its downfall, a power the new leadership seems to fear as well. Zena Khodr, Al Jazeera, Cairo.